Hello and welcome everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about scope in JavaScript, like the variable scope. What is the life of a variable in a particular block or a particular function, or maybe in the global scope? So consider we are writing we are creating one variable. Okay. Now we are writing a function. And here what I'm doing, here I have added name again. And I'm just trying the playing around it. And here I'm calling the cat name function, and again trying to do console.log the name. So what do you think, what will the output and how this will get executed? So let's see that. We already know what's going to happen. So console.log name is tks_sharma and tks_sharma. So the thing is, you are declaring a variable name Tarun here, that is fine. Now inside a function, you have added another property name, tks_sharma, in the function, and now you are doing console.log name. So the second one is fine, second one is going to be the tks_sharma. But what about the first one? If you see this expression closely, you didn't declare the variable. You actually, what you are doing, you are actually adding this variable to the global object directly. So whenever you say x equal to 30 or 90, it's actually gets added in the window object. Okay. So if you're not using the var keyword and creating the variables, then it's directly gets added to the window object. And that same thing happening here. So if you do the console.log, you can see the name is inside a window object. Let's do the cleanup here. Now you can see the global one. So now you will see the scope here. I can explain this in the better way with a zoom. So yeah, this is available outside of the function. This is available something inside the function, right? So console.log will look for the name property inside the function only. So it found it, right? tks_sharma. And now when you call that name, it will give you that value. But what about console.log name? Because the scope, now it is looking, not looking for the particular function, it is looking the variable name inside a global scope. And it found it somewhere above the function, right? So this name is available and it will be able to print that value. Okay. So whatever you are declaring inside a function is available in the function only. Okay, to consider this example, which is the best one. So you are creating a variable. What do you think? What will be the value here? Even you are not declaring. Let's call the get name. Right? So when you call the get name function, you can see that you are getting undefined. So I'm talking about this particular function. This is what you created. Now I'm calling this function get name. So it is giving us the undefined, right? So it is not giving any error, even if you just trying to access the hello property before it is being declared, right? So just a basic thing about the scope, that in the function it will try to access everything inside the function. So whenever you try to access some variable, it will look into the functions, and whatever the variable you declare, variable has a complete scope from this point till this point. This is actually the scope of any variable you declare inside a function. I mean, there is a variable hosting also, which we'll talk about in the next video. So every variable has this much scope, and whenever you are not using var keyword with any variable, that directly gets added to the window object, and whenever you access it anywhere, then you will get that value only if you are trying to access it from the global scope. Here you will get a TKS server, right? But here you will get the value Tarun. Okay, so whatever is in the function, that is a functional scope. Whatever outside the function, that will get added in the global scope. Like I'm using the var keyword now, it will not get added in the window object, but outside this function, if I try to access name, then obviously I will get the value Tarun. But inside the function, if I'm trying to access the name, then I will get the TKS server. And before the declaration of that and assigning the value, I will get that value as undefined. Okay, that's it about the variable scope and the declarations of the variables.